patient must lie down on a table in a relaxed position. He must place his hands across or over the chest. Drape the gown. The xiphoid process and symphysis pubis. Stand on patient's right side. First, inspect, auscultate, percuss and then palpate. Auscultation is done before percussion and palpation because they may hinder the characteristics of power sounds. Inspect the abdominal area, skin for color, any scar or marks or any bulging. Look for any visible pulsations over the epigastric region. Look the umbilicus appearance. Auscultate right lower quadrant where the power sounds are widely transmitted. Percuss the all four quadrants randomly. Percussion of liver. Place your index left hand index finger below the umbilicus in the clavicular line of the right side of the patient and percuss the area of tympani to the level of area of dullness. Mark the place or the region where you find the area of dullness. Resonance. Percuss up to the area of dullness to mark the upper edge of the liver. From 8th ICS to 11th or 12th intercostal space in the mid axillary line of the left side of the patient. That is up to the area of dullness. Place your left hand over the intercostal margin of on the left side and place your ulnar side of the fist and percuss. Right palpation. Ask the patient to mouth breathe with jaws wide open. Deep palpation. Keep your left hand over the right hand. As the left hand reinforces pressure on the right hand feels the organs. Breathe. Palpation of the liver. Place your left hand over the 11th or 12th rib at right back side. To lift the liver, place your right hand lateral to the rectus muscle on the front side. When the patient is exhaled, lift the left hand and while inspiration, feel for the liver edge. Place both hands side by side over the lower margin or lower border of the costal margin, that is over dullness area. Ask the patient to take deep breath. Feel for the liver edge when it comes down, that is during inspiration. Place your hand over thoracic 11th or 12th rib for supporting them and keep your right hand over the abdomen area. Ask the patient to take a deep breath. Try to feel for spleen tip. Place your left hand at the back to lift from the back and place your right hand over the front of the abdomen and feel. The bladder is not palpable unless it is distended above the symphysis pubis. Bladder volume is 400 to 600 ml before the dullness appears. Ask the patient to keep his ulnar surface of the hand over the midline of the abdomen. Place your hands on both sides of the abdomen. Keep one hand firmly and focus on the other side. Detect for fluid wave. Focus outward from the umbilicus from the region of tympani to dullness. Ask the patient to turn to the opposite side, that is to the left lateral decubitus position. Now focus the area where you notice to the area of dullness. Now you can say this is as tympani as the fluid moves to the opposite side. Press firmly over the left lower quadrant region and withdraw your fingers rapidly. Place your hand over here and place the right hand above the right knee and ask the patient to resist my hand. Flex your leg. Do you feel any pain?
No.
Extension in psoas sign. Now I am asking the patient to turn to left side. Place one hand over the hip and another hand at the ankle and extend his leg. Do you feel any pain?
No.
Asking the patient to flex his leg and internal rotate his leg. Do you feel any pain?
No.
Do you feel any pain?
No.
Now curve your fingers over the ribcage. Do you feel any pain?
No.
Do you feel any difference of pain?
No.
Place your hand over the anterior superior iliac spine. Place draw an imaginary line from the umbilicus to the anterior superior iliac spine. That below 2/3 of area. This is the place where McBurn is born.
The abdomen is intact.